Hello guys, this is Utkarsh and today I have got the SteelSeries Ikari optical mouse from SteelSeries. It is the cheapest SteelSeries mouse and it has a 1600 dpi sensor. So here's the side of the mouse box, the top, and it tells you about the LED technology, and in this is in other languages. SteelSeries tells about itself here, and so going to unbox this now. So you can keep your hand on this mouse so you can take a idea how this mouse will look like in your hand. So here's the mouse and the cable. Here are some do not eat silicone gels, and here is the manual which tells you about the CPI, which is 1600 CPI, how to connect, install the software, and that's it. It tells you about to go to steelseries.com/downloads to download the SteelSeries software. So here's the mouse. This is not steel, this is some plastic type material, and this is some not rubber but some matte finished plastic which feels good in hand. And here's the optical sensor and very big mouse mats. SteelSeries branding, SteelSeries Ikari optical mouse, 1600 dpi, the dpi changer. And here you get the 2 meter long cord which is the braided type, so it's going to last for a long time. Here's the gold plated connector, USB connector with SteelSeries branding here. SteelSeries branding. So I'm going to connect it to my laptop and this mouse is now active. As you can see, optical mouse, it is an optical mouse, so red light will glow here, then the DPI indicator are here. It is the high DPI and it is the lower DPI. Then two up and down buttons and left and right click. So if you change to low DPI here, low DPI, so if you move the mouse like this, and if you change to high DPI, it has increased its speed. So I'm going to open the software of this mouse. And you cannot do anything customizable, just you can change the DPI setting from low 600 low CPI which is 400 to higher CPI which is 1600, or 400 CPI and high to 800, and also low CPI 800 to high CPI 1600, and apply to mouse. And then you close this software. So if it's in now low DPI, so and when it is in high DPI, the pointer speed is now increased. So here are all the box contents that you get with the mouse. Here's a sticker that I didn't show you, as I gave it to a friend of mine. Then here is a pic which shows the comparison of the sizes of the different mouses. The leftmost is the SteelSeries Ikari, then to its right is Kura Master Mizar, then again to the right is SteelSeries Sensei, and the rightmost is the Razer DeathAdder 2013 edition. You can see that the SteelSeries Ikari is the biggest of all these mouses, and its shape is also different from all these mouses, and it is quite comfortable to hold this mouse.
And you can also see that all the other three mouses are giving LED backlighting of their brand logos, but SteelSeries only gives LED only to the side of the mouse, to the CPI level, the high and the low. And compared to SteelSeries Sensei mouse, the SteelSeries Sensei is made up of steel, but Ikari is made up of plastic type of material and some shiny type of plastic material which does not look good. Also the clicking in Sensei is more better than the Ikari, but surprisingly the SteelSeries Sensei and Ikari both have got same type of braided cable. These four mouses have got gold plated USB connector, and in SteelSeries Sensei you can customize a lot of things, but in Ikari you can only customize the CPI settings. But it is no wonder that Sensei is almost 2 to 3 times more costlier than the Ikari. So if you want to get a not good but decent gaming mouse and for your daily use, you can use SteelSeries Ikari. But if you want to go for serious gaming, then you should go for other brands that I show here. I will also give you a link in the description below of all these mouses. I have unboxed all these mouses, so you can see that and choose the best one.